Hi! If you own solar panels like me, you might want to store the solar energy you produce locally when you generate more than you can consume at that time. There are now suppliers that deliver home batteries, and I have tested the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2AC, which can store the surplus energy generated. But it does more than that, and it works with Home Assistant. Let's dive into this! I've had solar panels on my roof for years, and I make grateful use of them. Since I have a home studio, I work from home frequently and can run appliances like the washing machine and dishwasher during the day when there's plenty of sunlight. However, during the day, my solar panels produce significantly more energy than I use, which is a shame as I would prefer to use that energy in the evening. Here in the Netherlands, we currently have a net metering scheme, which simply means that the excess energy you generate is fed back into the electricity grid, and you can then draw the same amount of energy for free from the grid in the evening. However, this scheme will end on January 1st, 2027, and thereafter will only receive a small compensation for the electricity we return to the grid. A good solution to this is to store excess power in a home battery, allowing you to utilize that stored energy when the sun isn't shining. I recently installed the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 in my home, and I'd like to share my experience with this system. Before I show what's in the box, I'll first explain what the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 can do. The Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 is essentially a large power bank that allows you to store excess energy from your existing solar panels. You can also connect standalone solar panels to it using a micro inverter. I didn't do that because I already have a solar panel system installed. It features a 1.6 LiFePO₄ battery that is long lasting with approximately 6000 charge cycles and a 10-year warranty. The battery plugs directly into a standard AC outlet in your home, allowing you to recharge stored power. It has a 1200 watt bidirectional charging function, and according to Anker, it can save you up to 734 euros per year. If you connect the SolarBank 2 directly to your outlet, it will charge with 800 watts to its 1.6 kilowatt hours capacity whenever your solar panels produce more energy than you consume. In my case, the battery was fully charged early in the morning during summer. To automate the process, you currently require the Anker SOLIX smart meter, which I'll discuss in more detail later. Anker has also developed a P₁ meter, which will be available for shipment soon, but is not yet available. But that's not all. This system can be expanded with up to 5 additional Anker SOLIX BP2700 battery modules, each with a capacity of 2.68 kilowatt hours. That gives you a total maximum capacity of 15 kilowatt hours. And yes, this device features an off-grid function that enables you to keep a few essential appliances, such as your fridge, running during a power outage. I haven't tested that myself yet. Additionally, the Anker SolarBank is IP65 waterproof and features built-in heating to prevent the batteries from getting too cold, allowing you to install it outside your home as well. That's a comforting thought in terms of safety. In the box, you'll find a quick start guide that provides a simple explanation of how to install the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2. There are also a few cables included to connect it to either standalone solar panels with a microinverter or directly to your wall socket. And of course, the box also contains the Anker Solarbank 2 itself. It's quite heavy, but that's normal considering the batteries that it contains. That's it, nothing more. You can use the solar bank without the smart meter, but to truly make the most of it, the Anker smart meter is practically essential. The smart meter is a DIN rail unit that needs to be installed in your fuse box, and you can link it to the solar bank 2 via the Anker app. I also received an extra battery pack, the Anker SOLIX BP2700, which can be used to expand the battery capacity. Installing the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 itself took less than a minute. All I had to do was plug it into a wall socket. The cable is 5 meters long, so it's long enough to place the device in a suitable spot. As shown in the manual, you can stack the different modules on top of each other and mount them to the wall. Linking them together is very simple. You just snap the modules into place and you're done. There's also an option to connect standalone solar panels, but I haven't tried that myself. Installing the smart meter was a bit more complicated. If you're not familiar with electrical systems, it's best to have a professional installer perform the work for you. Luckily, I do have some knowledge of electrical systems, so I installed it myself. Your setup may vary from mine, and I connected it temporarily for testing purposes only. However, I'll definitely need to bring in an electrician to install it properly and safely. What you see here is essentially just a test setup. It's not how you'd want it to be in the end. When Anker releases the P1 meter, I expect that installation will be much simpler. Anyway, once everything was connected, it was simply a matter of adding the smart meter and the solar bank to the Anker app, and everything was set up. The app is easy to use. The main screen provides an overview of the energy generated and fed back to the grid, so you can clearly see how much you've saved. When the SolarBank 2 is charging or discharging, you'll see an animation on the screen, and the SolarBank 2 itself displays a light effect when it's charging. You can view graphs of your household energy consumption, how much power has been sent from the SolarBank to your devices, and how much has been fed back into the grid. This provides a clear picture of your energy production and usage, allowing you to gradually expand your system with additional batteries to match your total capacity with your energy generation. You can also configure various modes. The self-consumption mode works together with the smart meter and handles charging and discharging completely automatically. You can also choose custom mode, which lets you set schedules for when the SolarBank 2 should supply power to your home. This mode is especially useful if you don't have a smart meter. There's also a smart plug mode where you place an Anker smart plug between your wall socket and the SolarBank 2. In the app, you can set when the SolarBank 2 should charge or discharge, and the smart plug will turn the SolarBank 2 on or off accordingly. For example, you can set it to deliver power when consumption exceeds a certain level, or to charge when your solar panels are generating more energy than you're using. In addition, the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 is compatible with Shelly devices, so you can also use Shelly plugs, for example. There's also a schedule mode, which allows you to set up monthly schedules. The manual backup power option lets you connect devices directly to the SolarBank 2 and use it as a large power bank in case of a power outage. I've been testing the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 for a few days now, and I must say I've been checking the app multiple times a day to see how my home is being powered by the device. It feels great to see that the power you store can be used for free when there's no sunlight. As long as the net metering scheme still exists in the Netherlands, having a home battery isn't strictly necessary, but it's definitely interesting to see how it all works and to start preparing for the moment when you no longer receive compensation for the energy you feed back into the grid. In my case, I initially connected the smart meter to just one phase, and I noticed that discharging didn't fully cover the power demand. Some electricity was still being drawn from the grid. I'm going to test it further with all three phases. The system is really super simple. Once you've installed it, it pretty much takes care of itself and requires no further attention. During the testing period, my SolarBank 2, without any additional battery modules, was able to supply power to my home well into the evening, and in some cases even throughout the night, before the battery ran out of charge. That saves a lot on energy costs. While there's no official Anker Home Assistant integration, a community plugin now supports SolarBank 2 and the smart meter. I set it up, and now I see real-time battery status in Home Assistant alongside my solar production. This is great for energy enthusiasts. You can graph flows, set up automations, and more. There is a downside though. When you use the Home Assistant integration, the official app constantly reminds you that you have logged out and you must log in again. I found that quite annoying, but after creating an extra account, this problem was solved. Anker is actively working on more devices. Soon a P1 meter can be ordered, allowing you to make use of the smart meter provided by your energy supplier, making installation in the fuse box much simpler. The Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 AC1600 and the Anker SOLIX BP2700 both cost around €899. The smart meter costs €129. If you want more power, you can also opt for the Anker SOLIX Solarbank 3 Pro, which has a capacity of 2.688 kWh, has a power of 3600 watts, a 1200 bidirectional inverter, is expandable to 48 kWh and costs €1,499. After about a week of testing, I have identified the following pros and cons. The pros are plug and play. The system is easy to install, although the smart meter is a bit difficult. Expandable battery. You start with 1.6 kilowatt hours and can gradually increase to 15 kilowatt hours. High quality battery. The Solarbank 2 utilizes LiFePO₄ cells rated for approximately 6,000 cycles with a 10-year warranty, ensuring durability is a strong point. Waterproof and safe. The IP65 rating and built-in heating enable outdoor use down to minus 20 degrees Celsius, making it ideal for use on balconies or sheds. Also, LiFePO₄ is a very stable battery chemistry. On-grid and off-grid modes. Normally, it feeds stored energy into your home load, and in the event of a blackout, it automatically provides up to 1.2 kilowatts to keep essential devices running. And the cons are smart meter installation. Although the Solarbank 2 is easy to install, the smart meter may be a challenge for non-technical individuals, and you will likely need an electrician to complete the installation. Capacity and price. If you have higher energy needs, the 1.6 kilowatt hours base capacity might not be sufficient. To get meaningful backup or bill savings, you likely need multiple stacks. If you require a higher capacity, consider the Anker Solarbank 3 Pro, which boasts a capacity of 2.688 kilowatt hours, but you will pay a higher price. No local API. Since there's no local API, you must utilize the cloud to connect to your Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2. Overall, I'm quite happy with the Solarbank 2 system for my house. I didn't have any prior experiences with a home storage system. The Anker SOLIX Solarbank 2 helps me save on my energy costs, although the net metering scheme is still active in the Netherlands. It's only because I had the chance to test this that I have it now, otherwise I probably wouldn't have bought it until 2026, just before the net metering scheme was set to be phased out. But honestly, there's a good chance home batteries won't be available by then, as everyone will want one, so it's a good thing to already buy them. Thank you for watching and for your ongoing support. Thanks to your support, I am able to continue this work. You can also support me via Patreon, Ko-fi, or by becoming a paid member of my channel. Check the links in the video description. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you soon. Bye bye!